everyone. It's time to start on a new colorful resin painting again. And in this video you will see me pour the first two layers. And by doing that, trying to create the depth that I want. And also I'm using a lot of transparent colors and some opaque colors. And also that way I'm trying to create the depth. So for the people that are new to my channel and like tutorials, consider to subscribe, click the notification bell, and that way you don't miss anything. So back to the video. I already started with pouring the first colors onto my wooden panel, and this is a pre-gessoed wooden panel of 30 by 50 centimeters. And I didn't prime it myself, so I used it one time before, so I want to see how it does when I only use resin, because I used it one time before for my alcohol ink painting. And what I already mentioned, I'm going to use some very vibrant colors. The color on the right is a Bombay ink, the magenta, where I mixed in some Bling It Blue, red by Color Arts. The color next to it is the Bombay ink Bright Red, also some Bling It Red mixed into it. The yellow is the Resitint Brilliant Yellow, and the color I'm using now is the Wild Jasmine by Color Arts. And I'm pouring those colors next to each other, let them bleed into each other. This is only the first layer, so there will be more. So not too much effects on the first layer, because otherwise I will cover them up, and that's not good. So the white I'm using is the Resitint Max Titanium White. And the color I'm using now is the Bombay Ink Aqua, and also in this one I mixed some Bling It Blue in it to give it an extra sparkle. Now some heat to remove already some air bubbles. And I'm very curious how the wooden panel works only with resin. And again I'm using the Harion Resin Art Epoxy Cast Resin. I used it four times before and they all look amazing. The finish is great. It's just like glass, so that's good. So I want to see how it works when I use transparent colors and some opaque colors, not too much. Working on the sides. And of course I taped the back of my wooden panel with some masking tape, and also the sides to keep it as clean as possible. So I've used almost transparent colors except for the white. And I only used a few drops of the ink in my resin, not too much, because if you use too much then the resin will get very thin, the ink will thin it out, so that's also not good. So only a few drops. And the color I'm using now is from Color Obsession. It's the Turquoise Seas, and it's an opaque color. So on top of my transparent aqua color I'm pouring some Turquoise Seas, and that way you can also create depth by pouring opaque on top of transparent. There you can see it. Again, the heat gun. Trying to blend the colors, there you can see it. The Wild Jasmine over the Bright Red ink, and the white over my yellow ink. But I'm not looking for much effects. It's only blending the colors, also looking at my design, what I like. Trying to blow the turquoise seas over my aqua ink. Adding more of the white. So this will be a very colorful painting. I was in the mood for some vibrant, bright colors. And so, those colors I'm going to use. More white. Yeah, what I already mentioned, I'm using the Harion Resin Art Epoxy Cast again, and what I also mentioned in my previous videos, it's available for the people in Europe. I will put the link to the website in the description box, so if you're curious, then you can check it out. I'm very impressed by the resin, and I'm very happy that I can buy it here in the Netherlands. Because Stonecoat doesn't ship, but also this resin is great. It has a glass-like finish, and I like that very much. And it dries very well, so no wrinkles, dimples, or whatever. And it has almost 1 hour working time, so that's also good. The torch for the air bubbles, and then I'm done with the first layer. Then I need to let this dry for 24 hours and then I can work on it again. So it's 24 hours later and now I'm starting with the first color, it's the Resitint Max Mulberry, very nice dark purple color, because I want to have some contrast, and also by adding this second layer I want to create the depth that I want. So on top I'm using the Bombay ink magenta, again I mix some blinged red in it by Color Art, then the Wild Jasmine. It's more opaque than the Bombay ink magenta. They look similar, but the Wild Jasmine is much more opaque. And on top, some titanium white. And around it, some clear, so that it can flow into the clear. There you can see it. Trying to blow the colors into the clear. Again, some clear. Yeah, I always add bit by bit, because if you add too much, then you will cover up the whole first layer, and I don't like that, because I want to see that layer through the second layer, and that way you have your depth. So bit by bit I'm adding the colors. And I always pour clear next to the colors, because then it can flow into the clear. There you can see it. Again, the nice dark purple color, the mulberry. Now I'm using the bright red, it's Bombay ink, and in this one again the Blinged Red to give it a nice sparkle. Next to it the Wild Jasmine again by Color Art. A little bit of white on top. And some clear next to it. And then I will blow the colors, all the colors, into the clear. The next color is the resi tint, and then the solid yellow. It's a paste, it's very opaque, and then on top the resi tint brilliant yellow, that's an ink. And by using opaque and transparent and pastes and inks, you can create some nice effects, because one is heavier than the other. So the one that is heavy will sink to the bottom and the ink will stay on top, and then you have your nice effects normally. Some clear next to it. And again, I do the same. I will blow these colors into the clear. Again the same, the yellow, the solid yellow, the paste, then a transparent ink, that's the brilliant yellow, the resi tint, some white on top. and some clear next to it. And now I'm trying to blow those colors into the clear on top of the aqua color I have there, so that you have that depth. This is a nice dark blue color. It's the Resitint Max Ultramarine. On top, some Bombay Ink Teal with some Bling It Blue mixed in it. On top of that, the white. Because I think in this area there needs to be a little bit more contrast. That's why I've chosen this nice dark blue color. Now I'm trying to blow it into the clear. There you can see it. Again, the Bombay Ink Teal. On top, the aquamarine, no, the ultramarine, sorry. Then some white. Again, the clear next to it. And I do the same. Blow the colors into the clear. Now I'm using the Bombay Ink Aqua. The Turquoise Seas by Color Obsession on top of it. So again, an ink and then a paste on top. And the white is also a paste. And again, I will blow those colors into the clear. Yeah, I'm adding more of the mulberry color, the nice dark purple color, and I think it needs a little bit more there. So all the materials I'm using in this video are listed at the end of the video, but also in the description box with all the links to the websites where I buy my materials. And so if you are curious, then you can check out the description box. There you can see it, that I'm blowing the nice dark purple on top of the magenta color. Now I'm adding the flame orange, is a Resitint ink, next to the yellow. I think that looks nice, but on top of the red, and then that layer will shine through. I don't know if you can see it, but that way you can also create the depth. Now I'm filling the whole second layer with clear. Now you can see it. Spreading it with my stirring stick. Adding more white to the side. Trying to blend it with the aqua color. There you can see it. Yeah, I'm not totally happy with this corner, so I'm adding more of the ultramarine color. And again, some white on top and some teal. Yeah, at the end of this video, I will also show you a close-up. I hope you can see the depth then, because of the transparent and the opaque colors. Because it has some great depth and also some really nice sparkle from the Bling It pigments. The torch for the air bubbles. And then I'm almost done again. And then I will show you all a close-up. So this is how it looks now. It has some great depth and also some really nice sparkle. I hope you can see it. And there you can see the white on top of my aqua color and also the white on top of the yellow. I think the dark purple, the mulberry, is so beautiful. You can see there that the first layer is shining through. I also have some nice effects there. There you can see it. So I'm thinking about, is this finished or should I add more? But I normally step away. And then I can think about it, and the next day I will know what to do. Normally I have that, but yeah. Because I think it's already very beautiful, and there's some great depth already, and I don't want to cover that up. So if you like what I'm doing, please subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to give me a thumbs up if you like this. And the notification bell. It's all about the notification bell. If you click on it, then you get notified every time I upload a video. And all the information you want to know is in the description box. The links to my Instagram and Facebook page. Also to my influencers Amazon store. And my Etsy shop, where you can see what kind of art I make. And also my mica pigments I'm selling, you can find there. So again, I want to thank you all for watching, and let me know what you think of this painting, if you like it or not. I'm very curious what you think of these bright colors and if I should add more or not. So thanks again for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.